Hey everyone, I wasn't gonna do any running videos today, but this one was getting hung up, and I figured at whatever point I start doing or have the time within the next week or so to do videos, I wasn't gonna feel like pulling this one off the wall. So, and I also figured a lot of people would appreciate this because it's definitely a little more on the rare side. I don't usually use that word unless I actually truly believe it, because Montgomery Ward branded F&G machines don't come across often, and you certainly don't ever see or don't see many with the height accord, and this one is in relatively decent shape. The bag is in the best shape out of the whole machine, obviously missing the headlight lens, which would be nice to find. I'm sure it's not that hard to get. But anyway, we'll give it a quick little run here. It is a two-speed with a very awkward switch. I'm always one to point out when something is awkward to use, such as, where's the switch if you're looking at the machine? Can't see it. Now, normally, Eureka switches are right here, as this one is. But, to get my foot in there... kind of a little awkward. You got to be a little... toe touchy with it. But anyway, that aside, we'll give it a run. As you can hear, it has a little bit of bearing noise, but those little blender motors will go forever. Also weird that it has the two-speed switch as a foot push thing. From my recollection, usually when I see these type of machines with two speeds, it's a separate switch on the handle like the ESP has, I believe. But this model has it as a foot switch, and then I also noticed, which one is it? The other new one, the 2033, has it as the handle on the handle. Just a little side note. Oh, by the way, that it also show, as I mentioned, I was going to continue with the vacuums. I have now hung almost all of them up. I was all set to do these ones in the next bay, but realized, you can see that's not going to work too well, because there's the next bay. Is on this return duct, and it would put it right over this shelf with the ESP on it. So I guess those two will stay there unless I figure something out. I did two deep instead of three because based on my calculations, it would end right here if I kept them all equidistant apart, which was fine with me, and that included bringing in the three machines from the garage that I was thinking about keeping and decided I could keep them now with this increased space for them. I had to do a little rearranging on the design here. These two machines, I believe that's a 2061, and I don't know what that one is, but I didn't plan on putting these so close to the 2033 and the I forget what the blue one behind that one is too. I had to make room for that one, which I also don't remember the model number on, and the Montgomery Ward. So, got a little reconfigured, which is fine. I think it looks pretty sweet, if I may say so myself. Definitely, just picture how it was before, which would be all the handles sticking out like this coming across at you. It looked like a disaster. I think you can tell what's here a lot more, especially with these machines. And access to them isn't that bad. I mean, I pretty much just have to remove one or two vacuums out of whatever row the machine I want is in to get to them. And basically the only thing it does is hide the Oryx, which, I mean, really, who cares? They're kind of just hung there because it was easy storage. There's that. And Hope you enjoyed the Montgomery Ward's signature F&G branded vacuum.